Welcome back to Jaeger Racing and the Mustang series. So what we're going to be doing next is adding on this ZL1 tow hook. Welcome back to Jaeger Racing and the Mustang series. Today we're going to be installing the ZL1 tow hook because, well, every Mustang should have a tow hook. After we go sailing through that crowd and get perched up on that curb, we should definitely be able to get ourselves out of that predicament. Also, you know, it helps if something mechanical fails on track or something of that nature. I opted for the black on black version just because, want to keep it sleek, low key, and as it perches out of the front of the car, didn't really need to call any attention to the fact that I know that I can get myself out of a sticky situation. So, all right, let's get it bolted up, see how she looks. As you might be able to tell, the first step, we're gonna remove this belly pan. After we remove this belly pan, that's gonna give us access to behind the bumper. And then from there, we'll be able to get everything installed. Ford really wanted to make sure this will never fall off, so they put 100 bolts in. Pretty easy, you take that off. Now you have access to all the dirt under your car. And yeah. Then we find things like this little piece right here that was supposed to be attached to the condenser. Let's fix that. Keep that airflow going where it's supposed to. All right. So the part I didn't show you yet is this enormous, huge, heavy chunk of crap that bolts on here. Yeah, pretty impressive. So to give you a quick idea, the way that this is meant to mount, stabbing in the dark here, but you have two option holes. You can screw this in here or the one below, depending on your grill. And then these are where it actually mounts to the chassis. So now we just gotta take two gigantic bolts out and put it all in. So what you're doing is, you have these two bolts slash nuts here, and that's where those two holes are gonna mount. You have to take this off, and then take the bracket back, because this is gonna sit flush onto there. So you gotta take this, you gotta move this wire here, which is for your air sensor here, and they recommend you move this, so you don't break anything with that. And then wound up feeding it through this grill right here. Over here. Don't you love when it's like, oh, that feels like it's good and I can do it by hand. And then you try to do it by hand and it doesn't do anything. Shouldn't have to take them off. Just loosen them. Just so it's not fighting you the entire way. So if I was gonna give one little tidbit to the manufacturer, it'd be to drill a hole so I could stick my wire loom back through it. Because now you're covering the hole there. One thing that's gonna be important is making sure this fits where I want it to fit through the grill before I tighten that up, because there's a little bit of movement. So to give you an idea, this is what it's gonna look like behind your grill. I have a RTR grill. So obviously, I'm gonna have to do a little cutting to make sure that I can get
the actual tow hook through the hole.
I am no professional. Do not follow my instructions. Do not do what I'm doing unless you just don't care, kind of like me, and you just want stuff installed. So, I'm looking at the top hole as where I'm thinking I'm gonna like it best. I don't really want it at the bottom because this does have the ability to sit like this, and if someone's towing you in, I'm thinking I'd rather have this sit up a little bit higher so this can sit like that rather than sit down here. This is either where you have to be really confident in your abilities or just really don't care what it looks like. Obviously, you can also use some files, which I'll do at the very end. Or now. I want that really tight. I don't want it vibrating off because, well, I'll be honest, these tow hooks are kind of expensive. So as you can kind of see, it sits in there rather tight. I could probably cut down here one more. But I don't really care. So it's just nice and snug against everything, so I'm good with that. A little push up on the bumper. Do I want to display their logo? No, I want to display where it says tow. And again, just making it nice and tight. Ooh, look at that! So I have free range of motion, like I designed. So it can sit just like this. So I'm not gonna walk by and blow my knee out or shin or anything like that. It can sit nice and tucked away until the time that I need it. Hook it and go. So now the only thing that's left is just, well, put all the crappy stuff underneath the car back on. So let's do that. All right, we're all installed and ready to be towed out of the grass where we just mowed down a whole lot of people. Basically, you need like a 7 mil, 13 mil, maybe a wrench, a flat tip screwdriver, and a jack. Pretty easy install. And now you have the availability to actually get out of the little things that Mustang owners generally put themselves in. All right, check it out, and I'll see you again next time.